Hello everybody. In the beginning, we would like to say a big thank you to WDSF Academy for being here with you and giving us such a wonderful possibility to be a part of this wonderful project, which we believe very much. So, today our subject and ideas will be a little bit about the position and connection. Plus, also we're gonna explain and share with you our knowledge about rotations and sways. So, let's start. Yeah.
So, in the beginning, we constantly follow five steps and we have five oppositions. So you can try to do at home alone, together with your partner, before every time, before you take the position in the cup. So the first opposition is when we are rolling our shoulders backwards and down. So to do this action, we have immediately to see that the neckline and the shoulders line becomes very naturally and visible, the neckline. The second opposition is that with the hands we stretch maximum sideways. That we try to reach the wall each side. Correct. And then we go into opposition number three, which is lady and the man do the same opposition, the same step, but the lady is trying to do a bit more than the man. So with the left side, with the shoulder blade, we slide to the left. If I would show as well as a lady, so you can see that the lady is doing the step much more than the man. Number four is after the slide to the left, we slightly pick up the left shoulder blade up in order not to be heavy on the side of the shoulder blade. Especially this is important again for the ladies, it should be much more the stretch to the left and the lift of the shoulder blade much more in order to be still with the big volume but at the same time light in the man's right hand. And we are coming into the last one, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and number 5 is going to be that posture which we created already with the 4 steps. We roll through the foot by softening our knees to connect our two body weights together. So if we show sideways now together in front of each other, and we roll. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So in this case, as you see, it's actually very easy steps, but in the end, we already have quite big space between our heads, and the most important thing, we have very long connection. A little bit higher from the knee up until middle of the ribs. So as you can see, the distance of our connection is becoming very long. More longer connection we have, more stable cup we're gonna be on the floor. So once again, you can do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Now, very quickly, just one advice. When you are doing the last step, actually, which is connecting to each other, try to always remember, try to always start with the lowering of your body weight down, and then move the body in general as a one piece forward. It doesn't mean that we are actually pushing with the hip, or maybe we do opposite with the upper part, first touch here and then, which is, can be that because of those mistakes, not mistakes, but the other way, we're gonna reach the other result in the end. For example, if we do the normal position, let's say we start with the upper part first, I'm already creating a little bit unclear situation for the girl, what I want to do. And immediately, it's not gonna be as stable as it could be. So this, all those steps that we explain now, Ieva explain now and show, it's actually only for the stability of the couple. So every time, no matter the feeling, no matter which part of the day, if it's a morning, midday or late evening, you're gonna have the same situation as always, okay? Then, also one more thing, actually, which I would like to mention for the girls mostly. When you do opposition number four, we could check closely from this part. The position number four is supposed to be only the shoulder blade going forward and up, as you can see. This part is supposed to be carefully done. Why? Because normally if you make a small mistake and you don't pay attention for your shoulders, it can be that during this action you lift your shoulder up. And we don't want to see that actually. Also, second thing, what also can be bad as a mistake, it can be that during this picking up, you can go back and down with the right side, which is also not gonna be good, because in the couple, immediately the back of the lady gonna look very heavy. Okay, so in the best way scenario, when you make all those actions, when you do number three, number four, remember it's a small things, yes? So it's not gonna be visible that we are like that. Yeah. So it's just a little bit slide to the left, a little bit pick up the left shoulder blade, that's it. Okay? Then, when we have those five oppositions, we can speak now a little bit about the position in general. So when we stretch our hands to the sides, it's actually almost more than half we already did. So from now on, I need just to remember a few things. First of all, when I place my right hand, let's start from the right, because it's for some and for most of the people is the most difficult part. First, what I'm doing personally, I'm actually touching more or less this part of my hand with that part of the lady. So I already have a good sense of the weight and awareness of where she is. Yeah? From then, I'm actually placing my hand. And I'm not placing my hand very high or very wide. Yeah? So I'm trying to find this bone, shoulder blade, yes. So I'm trying to check where is the shoulder blade and what I really liked as an idea, I remember one teacher said to me, imagine like this, from the elbow till your hand, till your fingers, you're supposed to create an angle. And this angle is supposed to be like a continuity of the lady's spine. So with this idea, I'm always trying to pay attention and I'm always trying to make it. So lady is actually feeling quite comfortable into my hand. So if I make something like this, I can already create some problem for her because the shoulder is going up naturally because the lady starts to feel uncomfortable. Yeah? So once again, the hand is aside, stretched to the side, more or less into the shoulder, into the level of the shoulders, maybe a little bit more down, and then I bend it. And I try to create like an angle, yeah? With the left hand, it's actually a similar idea. I go to the side, I bend like this, and I place my hand more or less 45 degrees. Then, what are we going to do is actually, let's make a high five to your partner. Then, from this moment, you can see that it's actually vertically up. Now, what I'm doing, I'm opening, then lady is closing the fingers, I'm closing the fingers. If I would like to have a little bit more, let's say visually or by optics, a little bit wider look or the wider feeling, I can also make like, but guys, it's really a little bit, okay? So the angle, we can do a little bit like that. Not this, yeah? But also not gonna be inside. Why? Because sometimes during the sways, if my hand is vertically up, now the finger, yes? And I'm making a sway to the right, this hand can look a little bit like not beautiful, not elegant. So that's why I'm making a little bit like going out. So when I make a sway to the right, this hand, this part of the hand, is still looking a little bit more elegant. Yeah? Now, lady.
So it's more important, of course, is our left hand, which we are trying to put not important connection point is not the fingers on the hand, on the man's arm. We try to connect as the man, this part connects, first of all, we try to connect our wrist with the man's arm. So basically this slightly by giving 5% of my weight, it already gives more connection inside of the couple. And then we basically use or the middle one with the thumb or the showing finger. So your choice, this or this connection. And then we roll where is the triangle of the man's muscle. So wrist, and we place the fingers close together. The right one is actually the angle the man decides. So we are not trying to think about the angle. What is important to give this part of the hand with the slight support up. So it's again, I'm not grabbing with my fingers because normally the energy brings into the pulling. I always try to give more support feeling that I support slightly my man up.
Last, I actually forgot to mention, for the boys, like a small advice. I know that everybody is trying to have a perfect line with the hands, yes, but don't forget, it's not gonna be like at the same line of your, like a back. Hands in one line. Honestly, we are trying to actually, as Ieva already mentioned to you, we are trying to give some kind of energy and a space to each other. Okay, so as you can see, even like that, my right hand is not in one line with my back. Okay, because we have muscles, and those muscles, if I pull them back, they're gonna look a little bit crowded and I'm gonna look physical couple. So for to avoid that, we're actually giving the hands slightly forward. Okay? Now, we can quickly show how it looks like on the action together with those five oppositions, but already like fast away. Okay, so I'm not gonna mention like 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. I'm gonna do through all those steps immediately into the position. Okay, so first turn and forward. And now from the back, same as the lead. Now, as you can see, we are in the position. The next thing which is important, and it's like very important, we are rotating during our dance a lot. So it's not just moving forward, back, or to the sides. During our movement, we are turning a lot, or we are rotating. Now, we're gonna share one simple exercise with you, how you can already practice that rotation, most of your actually choreographies, and hopefully it should get a little bit easier, because for us it worked every time, and actually we are always warming up with those exercises, okay? As I said and I promised, we're gonna show that exercise, yeah? So I'm gonna ask my partner to do show it first slowly and solo without me. So I would speak and she would do as what I want. So it's actually very easy. So we all know slidyut, yeah? And we all know shase. So first, we're gonna do rotations to the right through shase. So what it's gonna be is one, and now she will turn to the right, and we have like a small rule, which, for example, is that the one who is going forward, yeah, and rotating to the right, supposed to in the beginning turn a little bit the upper part first, and then turn the center, the lower center, yeah? So as you can see, slowly one more time, One, two. From this moment, Ieva will go forward and turn the upper part of the body to the right. If she would do the same exercise and she would go with the back, one, and what she's gonna do in the beginning, she would turn first the lower part of the body and she will create a little bit of space for me. I will go forward and turn the upper part. And three. So in the couple actually, if you have a possibility to do it, it should look like this. You can even do without hands, just body connection. And one, and from now on, I'm gonna turn the upper part and then the lower. And one, and now I will turn the lower center first, as you can see. Yeah, so in the beginning, it's the lower center, and then when I will make a step, I will turn the upper part of the body as well. During that exercise, you should always maintain your spaces. So it means, if we are like that, and we are going to do one and two. As you can see, we didn't cross each other. And this is quite important, that during those rotations, our upper part of the body is not crossing, yeah? To the left, it's the same rule, just now we're gonna have one look actually more simplified. Doesn't matter if I go forward or back. In the beginning, I start my rotation with the lower center. So it's same with the slip pivot and chasse, just one end, and in the beginning, I will turn the lower center in the beginning, and now I complete my rotation. If I go back, I will make the beginning with the lower center again, and come to the upper part on the leg. And it's the same thing and the rule about the spaces. So, one and two, three and four, five and six, seven and eight. Okay? Now, about the sways. Sways, we have mostly two types of sways. First, we start the sway mostly from lower center, actually from the feet, the knees, the hips, and then continues into the spine. Second type of sway is actually more cosmetic. When we are switching off the lower center and we are trying to make all those sways with the upper part only. Okay, what is important to divide the centers, okay, because sometimes when we are dancing and we are trying to make some kind of sway, if it's a fast one and we do together with the hips, it's quite difficult to maintain a stable and a constant connection together. So we have to actually divide the center, the lower center, and then when we are making sway, as you can see, we are not including the lower part as well, okay? Now, we have like a small rule also, which is the one who is going and swaying to the left, making a bigger sway. So we are not making the same amount. For example, now I will make a sway to the left, and my sway is supposed to be a little bit more than the lady's. Because if she will make a sway the same amount or even more, she will cross me. The same to the right, but also if I make, for example, the right sway, which is lady's left, she's making more. Why I cannot, for example, make the same amount? Because again, you're gonna come in front of each other, plus also if you make a lot of sway, lady will lose a connection and a stability point from the men. So it is possible that we're gonna lose our balance in the couple. Okay? Last thing, which is actually not everybody use, but for us this information actually helped a lot about the rotations, and we have that exercise. So imagine this is our common center. Now, with the lower part, we're going away from each other to feel this resistance. Yeah? Now, what is important and what is the idea is that we are always turning around our common center. So with this exercise, what we have to feel, we have to feel this part, a tailbone. Yeah? So imagine we have a tail, and with the tail we're making this. So how it helps, actually it helps a lot, because during the dance, always we are turning around each other. Not one is turning around, let's say man is turning around the lady, or lady turns around the man. We are always turning around our common center. Okay, and this has actually helped us a lot to improve our rotations in every dance. Okay? So, guys, thank you once more to WDSF Academy for giving such a nice opportunity to be a part of this wonderful project. And we hope that we're gonna see all of you very soon and be together again. Thank you.